Hi everyone, this is Noelle from Petitti's, and we are in Buddleia, or butterfly bush land. I'm over at Oakwood Village, and we do have this whole section of Buddleia here around me, so I wanted to show you because midsummer is definitely a great time to attract your pollinators, and really the butterfly bush is indispensable as far as really color and variety and just really nectar-rich for those butterflies and pollinators, all pollinators. The hummingbirds love it, the butterflies love it, the bees love it. You'll see hummingbird moss around them too, so they really are a great plant to have in your landscape and enjoy. What you need for Buddleia to be successful is actually full sun condition. So full sun is 6 or more hours of direct sunlight, so we want them to be in full east, full west, full south exposure, no problem. They will do just fine. The other thing is they like to be in well-drained soils. However, I've found that they are fairly clay soil tolerant. The only thing that you want to avoid is when it does get waterlogged, which our clay soil can get waterlogged in the spring or the fall, when we do have a lot of rain. Just making sure that they are planted a little bit higher than your natural soil level so the water is draining away from them. That's always really, really beneficial. They are a plant that sometimes when we have very, very hard winters, we have to watch for. So I would recommend protecting them out and about. So if you do have them planted out in, let's say, a full western exposure, after they lose their leaves, if you can mulch them for a winter mulch about 5 to 6 inches around them, that's going to help them out tremendously and hopefully keep that root base nice and insulated, and of course the base of the plant insulated too. They sort of are a sub-shrub, if you will, so they tend to die back quite a bit over the winter time. And then in the spring, what you're looking for is you're looking for new growth coming out at the base. You are going to cut these butterfly bush back to where that new growth is flushing out. And we usually say about 6 to 12 inches tall, okay? With butterfly bush, there are some varieties that can get very large. And sometimes that's what you wanna achieve out in the landscape. For example, I have Miss Ruby right next to me. You can tell Miss Ruby is a taller butterfly bush. Don't get me wrong, we can keep her a little bit more compact in the landscape pruning wise, and I'm gonna describe that here in a moment, but there are some butterfly bush that are 5-6 foot tall, big round ovals out in the landscape. And then there are some like Lo and Behold, the Lo and Behold series, is very short and compact in the landscape, usually about 2 foot tall and 2 foot wide, right around there. There are some smaller, some a little bit larger, but they stay very, very nice and dwarf, if you will. So you have a lot of options color-wise and also form-wise, habit-wise, if you will, out in the landscape. So it just kind of depends what you prefer. As I was mentioning, late winter, early spring, when you get that new flush of growth, that's the time when you want to cut them back. Do not cut them back in the fall. They have hollow stems. The water and the ice and the snow will go right into those hollow stems. They will freeze and thaw and break. And that's where we have quite a few problems with butterfly bush. Over the winter, they just end up the stems breaking, and then you won't have your butterfly bush. They will not come back very well from that condition. So wait until that early spring, cut them back to 6 to 12 inches. And then as they put on a little bit more growth, and that's especially for the taller varieties, if you don't want them to get that 6 foot tall, go ahead and you're going to trim them usually once in, let's say mid to late May, early June, and you can take them down by half their height. It will postpone the blooming, so it'll delay the blooming later in the season, but they will be a much more compact plant and they will also branch a little bit more for you. So kind of depends. And I think it's really good to experiment, especially when you're pruning butterfly bush, to see what you prefer. And if you want to try doing that on half of the shrub and the other half, let go and see how you like the difference in the pruning. That's something to consider. I have a lot of different varieties around me. White ball is right here. White ball is an excellent white, stays nice and round in its habit. Beautiful, beautiful butterfly bush if you're looking for a pure white. Really, really nice. I was talking about Lo and Behold. Lo and Behold, again, very compact, almost like a ground cover at times, sort of has a weeping to mounded habit to it. Lots of different colors in the Lo and Behold series. This is lilac chip, so it's got that beautiful, just light lilac color. Really, really beautiful. I have two types of Pugster here. Pugster is a relatively new series for us of butterfly bush. What we like about them is not only are they compact, but they have very thick, strong stems. That provides them with a little bit better cold tolerance and cold hardiness. So we do really like the Pugster series. It's been developing really well for us the last 3 years or so. We've been growing it. Pugster Pink is down here. Pugster Blue is closer to me. I'm gonna tell you that it looks like Pugster Pink got cut back pretty hard, pretty tight. Pugster Blue didn't get cut back as hard. So it's a little bit bigger, a little bit wider, if you will. So again, experimenting with that pruning really does control the way that this plant is going to develop for you. The flowers on Pugster are very thick, very long, very showy too. So really a cool plant. Miss Ruby, as I mentioned before, there's Miss Ruby and Miss Molly. Fairly similar in standard shape and size. Coloration on the flowers is a little bit different. So look close when you're looking at them and comparing them. Miss Molly seems to be more of a magenta, if you will. Miss Ruby is a little bit more of a pinky red. So with these guys, again, just a little bit taller, but still beautiful bloomers. And the butterfly bush are repeat. Most of these newer varieties, if you continue to cut them back and just deadhead them, they will really continue to bloom and produce for you all the way into late fall. So you will have butterfly pollinator attractive qualities in your garden, you know, for a very, very long time, over several months for your pollinators. So that's really a great benefit. The other thing that I forgot to mention is we love the butterfly bush because they tend to be fairly good as far as deer resistance is concerned. They have a wonderful sweet fragrance to them, which is a great benefit. They also have fairly fuzzy foliage, which is also a great attribute that you're looking for, especially when it comes to deer resistance. So do look for the butterfly bush. Feeding wise, they're just like any deciduous plant that loses its leaves. You're going to feed them plant tone and iron tone once in the spring, and then again once in midsummer. You're done. They do great. Enjoy.